Thank you, Patty. That was lovely. Announcements. Welcome to First United Methodist Church of Oroville. I'm Betty Ledford, your liturgist for today. If you are visiting for the first time, we welcome you. Thank you for worshiping with us this morning. If you are returning guests, we thank you for coming back. Our prayer is that you'll continue to come and be a part of our church family. For the rest who have made First United Methodist Church your home church, thank you for your faithful attendance. No matter who you are welcome. All are invited to join us in the social hall for a time of fellowship and refreshments after the worship service. The social hall is located straight through the double doors. Are there any announcements to share with the congregation?
Tuesday night will be the first Oroville Concert Association concert of the season at the State Theater, and it's Danny Wells with a tribute to George Strait that he's called Straight From Me to You. So it should be a great concert. He sounds like a nice guy. I've talked to him on the phone. So be there or be square. Oh, yeah, 7 o'clock.
Yeah. Anybody else? Oh, Glenda.
Tomorrow is Circle at Elaine's house, and it's at 1 o'clock, so be there. Tomorrow is Circle.
I just want to remind you that if you look at the bulletin, the call to worship, we are going to do it differently today. As you can see, we have women and girls, they will say their part, and then the men and boys, they will say their part, okay?
There are things coming up. It's on the back of your bulletin, upcoming events, but I'll point out that today we have a church council meeting after service, and everybody should try to attend if they can. And then next Sunday, if you're on the Ross Harmon Educator of the Year Committee, there's a meeting after worship. And just a reminder, the first Sunday of October is a church potluck and the October birthday celebration. And also prepare or try to sign up to help with the turkey dinner that's on November 2nd and the baskets. The raffle baskets need to be ready by the turkey dinner. I think, okay. So at this time, you can share the peace of Jesus Christ with your neighbors in your pews. Thank you. Well, I guess I'll do the girl part. But you have to follow along with me. Okay. Phenomenal. That's what we are. Nurture, plan, care, for, prepare, volunteer, love, support, comfort, manage, conquer. We are strong, graceful, sensible, and thoughtful. We are marvelously and wonderfully made. Our brothers, fathers, sons, uncles, nephews, friends, and cousins, God has created and woven you into the same phenomenally wonderful and miraculous tapestry. Let us all shout, Hallelujah. Praise be to God for making each one of us unique. We are special and made in God's own image. Yes, we are God's delight. Hallelujah. Now, if you're able to stand, please stand for the opening hymn, Help Us Accept Each Other, in your red hymnal 560. Join me in the unison opening prayer. God, as a human infected with sinful desires, I know I often choose to stir up bad attributes in and out of my life. Show me how to flee these evil attributes and replace them with more of your own qualities. Allow me to show others what Jesus Christ looks like, and how to effectively seek his guidance and help with my baggage. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. And now the choir.
Thank you.
God is good?
All the time.
All the time?
God is good.
So I think if I heard correctly, Jeanette requests that we sing a happy birthday to make it extra special for Glenda, right? So Patty, do you have that on hand, and can you play by heart? Okay, so Glenda Arts.
Thank you. That was very nice. It was yesterday, but we're celebrating today because, well, my family wasn't here yesterday. That's why. I wanted to, for our joys and concerns, Larry and I saw Joe and Kathy Mooney this week, and Joe has cancer, and he's in chemotherapy. And Kathy was looking very good. She has a new prosthetic foot, and she looks and getting around very well. And she says she's well, so I hope that's true for her. But that's Kathy and Joe Mooney. And I just thought it was interesting that Baggage was a part of this sermon today, because Larry and I are going on a trip on Thursday to North Carolina, and we're taking a lot of baggage. But anyway, but it will also, it's gonna be a great trip, but we need prayers for our meeting with all of our family and our trip. That would be good, thank you.
Lord, in your mercy.
This week, Linda and I went to Carson City to visit my cousins, one of whom has been battling 9 years with colon cancer, and he's ending his battle. So we went to see him. And while that was sobering, watching both Norris and Kathy fighting the fight and making as best as they can. Matter of fact, they changed his medication Friday, but apparently I just heard from her, it isn't helping much. So anyway, prayers for Norris and Kathy Schultz so that they can go through this process and continue on.
Lord, in your mercy.
I have several prayers and concerns today. We'd like to pray for a friend of ours who's struggling in his marriage, and that his wife find continued strength for both of them until he is back in a better place. We ask for prayers for our friend Alex, who has brain cancer, and our friend Tom, who has pancreatic cancer. Both of them are in stage four and are doing radiation and chemotherapy to prolong their lives at this time. Today is Military and Veteran Suicide Remembrance Day, so I ask for prayers for the 30-plus military members and veterans who have lost hope every month. They are so desperate that they take their own lives. I ask for prayers for the 200-plus veterans who die every month waiting for care, that these people who honor us by serving our country should not be treated in such a manner that they find suicide an option, or that they die waiting for the treatment our government owes them.
Lord, in your mercy.
A joy, well, kind of a joy and a concern too, I suppose. Today would have been our parents' 80th wedding anniversary, and Mom's birthday would have been Tuesday. So they're on our minds a lot this week. And just for those of you that knew them, they were very happy here. And we have lots of good memories here of the church with them. So thank you all for supporting them while they were here. I have a couple of concerns. My grandson, Jacoby, he's not quite six, is really, really struggling with some behavioral situations, primarily because his parents can't get their act together. So I would ask for prayers for Jacoby and his mom and dad as they all go through this difficult time, and for his school that is really trying to support him as well. And then lastly, a friend of mine, Deanna, she found out this week that her mom has breast cancer and that her dad has melanoma. And so she takes care of both of them, so she's just kind of struggling. So I would ask for prayers for all of them as well. Thank you.
First, God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good.
Lord, in your mercy. Let us pray. Forgive us, Lord, for not asking for your insight. Fill us with your wisdom, that we may live lives of goodness and peace. God of mercy, we have brothers and sisters who need your healing miracle. We ask your blessings on them and restore them to wholeness. There are those who need your guidance to return home. Lead them. There are those who have become estranged to family and friends. Welcome them back to a relationship. There are those who have lost their homes because of fire, flood, and hurricane. Please provide for them. Use us as your instrument of love. And there are many other names that we lift up to you in their difficult situation. Protect them, bless them, comfort them, and be with them. We thank you, eternal God, for your Son, Jesus, who taught his disciple how to pray. And now we come saying that prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Please join us in singing Forgive Our Sins as We Forgive in United Methodist Hymnal number 390.
Thank you.
The scripture reading this morning is from Ephesians 4, 31 to 32. If you're able, please stand for this reading. Thank you. Get rid of all bitterness, rage, and anger, brawling, and slander, along with every form of malice. Be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other, just as in Christ God forgave you. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Far too many people walk around carrying heavy baggage from years of mistakes, hurt, pain, bad choices, etc. In Jesus, there is no condemnation for past mistakes because we are given the gift of eternal grace. It's time to unpack all the worthless weight we are carrying around and learn to live free. Some of the baggage we carry around us is bitterness and anger because of past pain and frustration. This can spill over into our current and future relationships and create collateral damage. We have to let it go. We have to choose forgiveness and repentance in order to be kind, tender-hearted, and loving toward others. Let us begin our new 3-week series by learning to let it go. Obviously, to let go of an issue, we must first understand what the issue or problem is. In Ephesians passage, we read a few minutes ago, Paul identifies 7 specific things believers need to get rid of. And they are bitterness, rage, anger, brawling, slander, every form of malice, unforgiveness. And honestly, this is just the tip of the iceberg when it comes to the range of negative emotions, feelings, and attitudes we often carry around with us. But where do they all come from? Surely, it's not like people just wake up in the morning and decide to be bitter or angry. I have never heard anyone say, "I sure hope someone does something awful to me today, so I just can withhold forgiveness from them." I have never heard one say that before. And yet, if we are honest about it, there are many of us who silently hold bitterness, anger, envy, etc. in our hearts toward others. So the first step to letting it go is identifying what you are carrying around. Here are a few ideas to get the identification process started. 1, bring the process to the Lord in prayer and ask that He help to reveal any areas holding you back. 2, bring the process to some trusted friends and ask them to help you identify any obvious areas of trouble or blind spots you may be missing. 3, if you don't already have a professional counselor and advisors in your life, then find one and schedule an appointment. It's unfortunate that there is a stigma against counseling and therapy in our culture, when the fact is, the Bible is very much for trusted counselors and advisors in our lives. Where there is no guidance, a people falls. But in an abundance of counselors, there is safety. That's Proverbs 11:14. Listen to advice and accept instruction, and in the end, you will be wise. Proverbs 19:20. Plans are established by seeking advice. Proverbs 20:18. What are some other ways you can identify baggage in your life? Once you have identified areas of baggage, the next obvious step is to do something about it, to get rid of it, to let it go. But thanks be to God that His plan for you is much bigger than just letting it go and being done with it. He is interested in healing, restoring, and seeing you walk in freedom. Listen to these words from John, 1 John. If we claim to have fellowship with Him, yet walk in the darkness, we lie and do not live by the truth. But if we walk in the light, as He is in the light, we have fellowship with one another. And the blood of Jesus, His Son, purify us from all sin. If we confess our sins, He is faithful and just and will forgive us our sins and purify us from all unrighteousness. In the book of Colossians, the Apostle Paul says that you have been rescued from the dominion of darkness, that you and I share in the inheritance of the saints in the kingdom of light. Things like bitterness, anger, malice, slander, unforgiveness, etc., are characteristics of the worldly system, but not the kingdom of light. As believers, it is so important for us to regularly evaluate ourselves and consider the fruit we are producing. When we identify and recognize rotten fruit, baggage, we bring it into the light. We confess and ask forgiveness, or in some cases, extend forgiveness to others. And God, who is faithful and just, forgives and purifies. I know this all sounds amazing and wonderful. And who doesn't want to walk in the freedom of the light, unhindered by excess baggage? So what do you do when the baggage is too big, too heavy, and too difficult to work through? The process of letting go can be a long and difficult one. The process of identification can take significantly longer than you think it should. The process of coming into the light might not be a simple hop, skip, and jump from one place to another. There may be times when the baggage feels too heavy. That's when we remind ourselves, with God, all things are possible. Let's repeat that together. With God, all things are possible. Indeed. And we must be willing to trust the process. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 3 says, as clear as day, it is God's will that you should be sanctified. And that process is a lifelong one. Not a day, not a week, not a three-month internship at your childhood summer camp, not a 20-year journey in local church leadership. It's not any one of those things. It's all of them. The process of sanctification is all of life, and God uses all kinds of situations and circumstances to constantly conform us into His image, the image of His Son, Jesus Christ. With this in mind, let me ask you a question today. Do you trust God? Do you trust God? Do you trust that He has a plan and a purpose for your life, that He will work it all together for good, that there may be situations the enemy meant for evil, and yet God will use this for His good in your life? If the answer is yes, then let go of the baggage and get moving. Today is as good a day as any to say goodbye to the anger and bitterness you have been holding onto. Let us say goodbye. Goodbye. It's a good day to let it go. Let it all go. So as we wrap up today, I want to draw your attention back to the words of Jesus in John chapter 10. This is what Jesus explains to His disciples. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I have come that they may have life and have it to the full. Some translation says, I came that they may have life and have it abundantly. The enemy wants to steal, kill, and destroy you. One of the ways this can be accomplished is by weighing you down with so much trouble and baggage through your life that you simply cannot move forward. But Jesus has come that we might experience abundant and full life in the light of the kingdom. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1 through 3 says, therefore, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, let us throw off everything that hinders and the sin that so easily entangles, and let us run with perseverance the race marked out for us, fixing our eyes on Jesus, the pioneer and perfecter of faith. For the joy set before Him, He endured the cross, scorning its shame, and sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. Consider Him who endured such opposition from sinners that you would not grow weary and lose heart. Again, do you trust God? Do you trust He has a plan and a purpose for your life, that He will work it all together for good, that there may be situation that the enemy meant for evil, but God will use for His good in your life? Throw off the baggage weighing you down. Run the race of freedom. Live in the light. Amen.
Thank you.
God of love and mercy, we bring these offerings with grateful hearts, honoring your enduring guidance in our lives. Just as wisdom works with willing hands and provides for those in need, may these gifts be used to nurture and uplift our community. Inspire us to follow your teachings of kindness and generosity. Transform our contribution into acts of love and justice, spreading your light in the world. May we always give credit to your divine wisdom and grace. In your holy name we pray. Amen.
Please join in singing the closing hymn, Leave It There, in your hymnal number 522.
Live the freedom lives that Jesus came to give us full and abundantly. In Jesus' name, amen.